that I read was The Tomorrow Code by Brian Faulkner. And it's basically about how these, it started off as two kids, but later becomes three kids. These two kids find out how to get messages from the future using gamma rays. So basically they use those messages to, you know, like help themselves, you know, like throughout their lives. And it turns out one of the messages tells them that there's a giant virus that will wipe out the population of New Zealand. And so when the virus actually happens, they don't know fully what to do, but they keep on getting like these, like, what's it called, these messages from the future. They don't know who gave them the messages. They think that it's themselves giving them, but they use those messages to basically just like help them with their lives. So yeah, basically the two characters, their names are Rebecca and Tane. And then later on, the third character that comes, his name is Fatboy. I don't know why. Is his name Fatboy?
He's got blubber.
No, he's just called Fatboy. And so, yeah, the two characters, Rebecca and Tane, they're good friends. And Rebecca, Fatboy is actually Rebecca's boyfriend. So Tane's a little jealous.
Plot twist.
But, yeah, the messages, though, since they're in gamma rays, they can't get, like, the full meaning. Basically, like, the messages, it's hard to explain, but it's like, you know how Michael, from his, like, last book, he told how, like, text messages weren't really, you know, like, they didn't complete their words. Like, in his book last time he did his book talk, he read out a text message from some certain kid from his book. And it was, like, not in complete words. Like, these gamma ray messages, they're, like, the same. Like, they don't really have, like, the full spelled out words. It's, like, it's hard to explain, but when you read the book, then you'll get it. So then, let me find a quote that I don't really have a favorite quote. There are a lot of cool parts in this book, especially towards, like, the middle. It gets really action-packed. So I just suggest that you read this book if you really like, you know, action-related stuff. And if you're into, like, science overall. And, oh, yeah, and I also give this book a rating of 4.5 stars.